Matt Wehmeyer alongside Dan Rosen. It's 31 teams in 31 days with the addition of a new NHL franchise. But today, a franchise which is most certainly not new. The Boston Bruins, original six. The Bruins back in the playoffs in 2017 for the first time in 3 years. But their stay in the postseason rather short-lived as they fell to Ottawa in six games. And Dan, this Bruins team didn't do a whole lot in the offseason. What is Don Sweeney's mindset right now?
I think Don Sweeney's mindset is he wants to see the young players and he wants to see how they will perform with the team. He thinks they're ready. Certainly one guy, Charlie McAvoy on defense, he is certainly ready. He looked the part last year. He made his NHL debut in the playoffs against Ottawa, played in all six games, and he played more than 24 minutes in every game, and he looked very good. He, to me, slots right in on the top pair D with Zdeno Chara. McAvoy on the right, Chara on the left. Now, the other couple of guys we're talking about, Jacob Forsbacka-Carlson and Anders Bjork, two forwards who should be able to push four roster spots this season. And then there's another young guy there too, and David Pastrnak, who we've seen what he can do. Pastrnak's still a restricted free agent. He is subject to an offer sheet, but I find it very hard to believe that the Bruins will let this guy out of their grasp anytime soon. So I think Don Sweeney's mindset is, I've got all these young guys, I've drafted a lot of them, I want to see how they can do.
Bruce Cassidy, of course, entering his first full season behind the bench in Boston in the final 27 regular season games. Pretty good. 18-8-1 went Cassidy with the Bees. And Dan, in the last three seasons, only Braden Holtby of the Capitals has started more games in net than Tuukka Rask. And I think the biggest question here, did the Bruins ask Tuukka again to take on a huge workload?
Well, that's the thing with Tuukka Rask. I mean, that's the biggest question. Can he handle it? Can he continue to handle it? Tuukka Rask, 60-plus appearances again? That's what they could be looking at here. And think of it. In the past three seasons, he's had 70, 64, and 65 appearances, respectively, 67, 62, and 64 starts. It's a lot of action. My point there is it's a lot of action for Tuukka Rask. He's 30 years old now. The Bruins might want to cut back on his workload. Anton Khudobin is his backup. Can the Bruins cut back a little bit on Tuukka Rask's workload and still be a team that fights for a playoff spot? That's the biggest question for them. Khudobin's got to play well, and they've got to be willing to cut back just a little bit. Even 55 appearances would be good for Tuukka Rask. I remember with the Rangers a couple of years ago, they decided they wanted to cut back on Henrik Lundqvist's workload, and there's been times where Lundqvist has been hit or miss and injured a little bit, but he's been very good, I think, on the whole, since they've cut back on it. I think they probably have to do the same here with Rask.
A lot of debate if the Bruins are going to be a playoff team again in 2018. They're one of those teams at times very tough to figure out. What do you say?
I don't think they're going to be a playoff team. I think they're right there. They're right on the bubble. It's going to be a tight race. But the way I see it shaking out is five teams from the Metropolitan Division and three from the Atlantic. I just think the Metro is too deep and too good. And I don't have the Bruins among the three from the Atlantic Division going to the playoffs this year.